see all the Beatles scruffs around the nation and the world on YouTube. And Carly, thanks for putting me on.
Quick note before we begin the actual video, please listen to this part just in case you decide to tune out, because I know this is a long video. So, if there's anything you have to listen to, it'll be the next part. It's not even that really important. That really important, that made no sense. Just listen to it, and then watch the rest of the video if you want to. So, yeah. Bye. Next Saturday, I'm not exactly sure what I'm gonna be doing, but I definitely know I wanna make a video, and I don't have too much time, but I definitely do have a little bit of time that I can do, like, a questions video. So if you guys wanna ask me some questions, then I would be more than happy to answer them for you. So if you wanna comment on this video, comment on our channel, ask me on Formspring or Tumblr, but specify that you wanna answer in video form, then, yeah, that'd be totally fine. I'd love to do a question video for you because I don't have any ideas. If you have ideas of what I should do instead of a questions video or in addition to a questions video on Saturday, just let me know. Like, if you want to see my tree again or something, or if you want to see my cats dance to Feliz Navidad, I don't know. I don't know. That has nothing to do with the Beatles, but that was the first thing that came to mind besides the Christmas tree idea. There's something wrong with me. I need sleep. So, yeah. If you have any ideas for something else I should do, then just let me know somewhere, and I will get to it, and it will be a very, very fun, happy Christmas. And now on to the actual video.
Oh, hello! I didn't see you there. Hello, BeatleScruffs people, how are you today? Now, as you saw a couple seconds ago, we had a very lovely gentleman introduce today's BeatleScruff video,
and that man was...
Larry Kane,
who was a journalist, and he was the only American journalist that went with them, I believe, on both of their American tours. Just a little history about him. He started off in Miami, Florida, and then actually he was a reporter in Philadelphia for a while after. He, of course, after being with them for so long, he developed his observations and personal opinions on each and every one of them. So we're going to basically summarize his observations and opinions on each and every one in the John Paul George Ringo order. Would you like to discuss that?
Indeed I would, Vanessa.
All right. Discuss on.
So, there's a story of the Beatles. They just earned an award, and unfortunately, neither of us can remember where or when this happened, where the... there was an award luncheon happening in London. We don't know what the award was for or and whatnot, but the Beatles couldn't make it because they were on tour. So Larry decided to interview them on the plane. So he has this recording of John, Paul, George, and Ringo accepting this award and just thanking everybody. And what's very interesting about it is Larry wasn't necessarily holding the microphone as he interviewed them. What happened is after John was finished, he automatically handed it to Paul, who automatically handed it to George, who in turn handed it to Ringo. As, like, how everybody views them as John, Paul, George, and Ringo. It's very rare that you hear them being referred to as, like, George, Ringo, John, Paul, and, you know, that sort of thing. So it was very fascinating. He pointed that out and said it was a very cool thing to witness.
I wanted to talk about John first. Now, John and Mr. Kane had their own connection because they both lost their mothers at a semi-young age. He felt, you know, John and him had a connection.
Before I go into Paul, I would just like to mention that for some reason, we are both having major brain farts and cannot remember what happened in the past 3 hours. We don't know why, and it's really annoying. Mm-hmm. If anything pops up in my memory during the next week, because this is Sunday, so we have quite a few days to figure this out, I will include it afterwards in the video. Mm-hmm. Alrighty, so Paul, he was kind of like the second Beatle that he most identified with in a way. George and Ringo were somewhat quiet with him, but Paul and John were more open to talk. He described Paul as slightly insecure, which is something you really typically don't think about Paul being, because he's a very, very confident man. You see him on stage, he just radiates confidence. And he mentioned how he's insecure about, he just really wants to be loved growing up. Even now, he just wants to be liked, he just wants to be loved. and which was something very fascinating. You don't really notice it until it's mentioned.
George was, as Mr. Kane said, the unsung Beatle. Basically, George deserved a lot more credit than he was given, is what Mr. Kane was saying.
Something else very interesting about George that he kept on mentioning throughout, whenever he described the four Beatles in a situation, he'd be like, okay, John's doing this, Paul's doing this, Ringo's doing this. And every time he mentioned George, George was reading his Green Hornet comic book.
And he was usually in a corner.
Last but not least, our dear Ringo, who he described as being the luckiest man on Earth. What he said about Ringo was that he was more intelligent than people give him credit for. He knew what was going on. He liked to have political discussions. He liked to talk about what was going on with the world. But nobody really knew that. Everybody just basically talked to John and Paul. As many of you know, because all of you are hardcore Beatle fans, is that he was happy. That was something he stressed a bit, that while they were watching A Hard Day's Night for the first time, I think it was like a...
And that's when my camera ran out of memory. But not to worry, I have plenty of takes from before that. So, I'll have part two up soon. And note how I say soon and not a specific date, because that's how my life rolls, apparently. And that's partially because next Saturday's Christmas! Simply having... Tune in! But first, hang out with your family and or friends. If you celebrate the holiday. If you don't celebrate the holiday, still hang out with your family and friends, because it's nice and they love you. And then, come back to this channel, because... The BeatleScruffs are third on your list. Wink! I need sleep. So, back to Larry Kane. The CD right here, I shown you in the beginning of the video. Me and Vanessa got this for free at the discussion. And it's fantastic. I just put it in for the first time today, and I was pleasantly surprised to see it's full of interviews with them. I was expecting it to be Larry Kane talking about his experiences with the Beatles, which, of course, I would have been pleased to listen to, but, like, I just wasn't expecting the interviews, and I was like, this is amazing! I've never before heard interviews, well, by my ears, at least. I don't know about you. So, they're great, and you could tell, like, the first thing I noticed was, the first interview that, was on here was him and Ringo. And the first thing I noticed about these interviews is that the Beatles sound completely relaxed and just completely honest with him. Not like they're not honest in any other interviews and whatnot. Just like, usually when you hear interviews with them, they're things like kind of making fun of them. Like, when are you going to get your hair cut? Or there are rumors like, are Paul and Jane getting married soon? And, but he actually asks good questions. Did anyone else notice? Like, I'm sure someone did, because my friend Emily noticed that in the movie, when John and Julia went to Blackpool, I believe, they were on a pier or something, and she was acting, dare I say, like his girlfriend. And it was just very strange. I was weirded out. I was like, what's going on here? So does anyone know what the story is behind that? Does it have to do with the fact that she always had to have a guy with her? Because, that's what the movie and this book that I'm reading say. So, have a wonderful week, guys. I love you all, and I'll see you next Saturday. Goodbye.